What we talking about? So what is going on, y'all? You know what the day is. It's Busy Will Be Mondays. I'm in the studio rolling solo. No guests. You're stuck with me for an hour unless I run out of things to say. But guess what? Y'all gonna help me. So y'all stuck with me. Shout out to Sandy. I got the Facebook in front of me. But I'm trying something today, guys. I'm trying to look straight at the camera. Because when I watch a lot of my playbacks, I'm always looking at the TV. So it's a TV sitting right directly in front of me. So I'm always looking at myself. I'm full of myself. I love myself. This is just a lot of love going on with that. So today I'm doing something new. I said, well, maybe if I move the camera over and I put things right in front of me, I can show the camera directly some love. So be patient with me, because a lot of you guys don't know that I was cross-eyed when I was younger, right? So I have this conscious thing that I need to look directly at myself. So I'm doing something different today, but love on me anyway, okay? So, So today we talking about everything. We talking about the latest news. Of course, I have to start with talking about myself, guys. I want to open up the show. We talking about whatever comes up. So if you joining me on Facebook, shout out to Johnny. Where you been, Johnny? But if you joining me on Facebook and you want to talk about something that I may touch on or something like that, just drop it right here. I will be doing some call-ins eventually. I do got some friends stopping through. Who knows what the show will turn out to be. But today I wanted to just start my show or start the show with today was just, my day was just heavy and rough, right? So a lot of times I really don't talk about just my spiritual journey of where I'm at. Today I brought my sage to the studio. I do a lot of this stuff at home, right? And today was so heavy. It was so emotional. And for whatever reason, it started this morning. I woke up. I really couldn't sleep. I know I'm an early riser anyway. I'm a 3:30, 4 o'clock riser. But I actually was up earlier than that, and I started meditating and talking to God and my ancestors and my spiritual guides, and I really didn't know what today was going to entail. But what I did ask was for me to be able to listen to my intuition. So I don't really talk about my part-time job, right? Because this is everything that I'm doing full-time. I'm in the community full-time. I'm Busy With B full-time. But I'm going to talk about what I'm doing, because I would like to just talk about some of the things that we go through in the workplace. So I'm going to lay it on y'all thick today, guys, because today was so heavy for me. And it was a build-up. For the last couple of weeks, I've been going through a heavy at work. And I'm always like, why me? Like, I don't bother nobody. Exactly what you guys see right here when you meet me on this screen right here. I'm smiling. I'm bubbly. I am exactly who I am. I try to carry myself with integrity and be honest and treat people how I want to be treated. And so when things happen to me in such a way, I'm always questioning, why me? You know? But today, I just got so much confirmation. Why not me? When you know you are special, right? I'm a chosen one, right? So when you know you chosen and you right there at a breakthrough or a big biblical moment, so many things come against you. And I mean, things that you know you can prepare for, or, you know I didn't manifest or ask for, but it's just been, when I tell you, so heavy, a distraction. Just everything just trying to distract me from exactly what my purpose is. And I mean, just workplace, just, oh my goodness. I mean, you ever had like just a boss or, you know, people around you that you feel should be, you know, happy? And I mean, I know we all have a job to do, but it's just like, I mean, Mike, it's just been real heavy. So he calling me, he talking about, hey, sunshine, how your day going? I mean, and I was leaving out of an investigation interview, you know? And so, yeah, it's been real heavy. On top of that, and it was a meeting after a meeting in front of, you know, people. You got to think on the spot. Of course, when I'm doing what I love, I can just come up with some things. But it was a heavy day today, emotional. And then I ended up getting a phone call from one of my family members. and she was just dealing with some heavy things, and I had to be there. So I was trying to prepare to be in front of you guys, but I had to just listen and be there for my family. And so when I say today leading up to now has been heavy, I mean, it was real heavy, but I'm just sharing that. You just never know what people are going through. And when you are a chosen one, the right people will know exactly what that is. When you on your way and you walking in your purpose. So even when you don't understand things, you got to trust the process. And so I'm releasing it. I'm really tired of fighting the forces. You know, you want to change my schedule. You want to do this. You want to do that. I'm just learning to let go. Even when I don't understand it, just trust God, you know. So my advice is just walk by faith. You don't always understand everything, but trust your process, you know. And I always, you know, when I'm in here and I'm talking about, you know, my business life as far as my work life, I always have to kind of tread lightly and code things that I say. So I hope you got the message through the message, okay? But what I want to talk about is so many things. And did y'all check out these Buzy With B mugs, by the way? Okay, cute. What's on my, Kim! She got pink on today. Woo! So guys, so in light of clearing some of my energy, I told you guys I brought my sage to the studio. I needed to say some of that energy just out of the way. And I'm going to tell you guys, if you don't, I mean, I graduated to saging. I took everything in steps because when I was going through my process, I didn't always understand. And I didn't want to play with anything. I didn't want to play with the ancestors and the spirit guides. So I do feel like I've reached a certain spiritual level. So, I mean, it's all about just feeling your energy. Just looking yourself in the mirror, looking straight at yourself, telling yourself you are enough, you powerful, you're successful, you're abundant. I am abundant. So I'm going to talk as if I'm talking to myself. It's okay to affirmate, speak over yourself because no one will. So speak over your kids. You let them know you are enough. You are beautiful. You are powerful. So I just do some of these things. I look myself in the mirror and I tell myself, I go over on my chakra. I just let myself know everything that is a dream of mine will come. I will see it. And I just look myself in the mirror. Because a lot of people will look at me and say, you are so pretty. You are so beautiful. And the year that I went through last year when I couldn't lift my own head up, I couldn't look myself in the mirror. I couldn't look myself in the mirror. I couldn't look at my beautiful baby that I just had. So it's a lot of things that I've made it through that if I didn't talk to myself, if I didn't speak over myself, would I even be sitting in front of you guys? So I don't want to get emotional, but like I told you, today has been really heavy. So I'm glad to see a friendly face because she's going to have to give me a hug because I really just need a hug. Like I said, today was emotional. It's just been emotional. I'm carrying a lot of emotions. And I wanted to sage before I left the house today, and I didn't get to do that. So I brought it with me. So it's going to be here. But I'm going to lighten the mood. Can you put some music on real quick? Some Getting Buzy With B music real quick. The best song that's not on the radio. Real quick, just to change the energy. Can't depend on politicians, gotta watch our own back. Put the guns down, youngins. Life's about fun. Shout out to B Street Jizzle. Give money, shout out to VA and PG. You see us coming, MD. I need it up a little bit. Getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Getting busy with me. Getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Got to send this stuff to the studio. So I wanted to lighten the mood real quick. It was a little heavy. You know, I was getting a little emotional, you know. It's crazy. You should know today heavy, because you guys have been following me, been supporting me. You have been watching the shows. I've done had moms in the studios, and it's like I'm always the one holding it together. And it's just like, if I don't say today was heavy, I really mean it was a heavy day. But I want to celebrate since they here, right? Because they don't know what I'm... One thing I know about Will to join me if I need him to, right? But, you know, I wanted to lighten the mood. And first of all, I thought I sent the pictures to the studio. They on my phone. But I'm going to make sure I got my pictures with you. You know when you really love somebody, you get excited, you know, on their happiness, right? And so it's been a really short friendship with this young lady. You know, it been really quick and fast. You know, it was like a quickie, right? But when I tell you, full of just energy, full of life, you never know what you're going to get with her. But she keep me on my toes. And I like her because she challenges me. You know, a lot of people don't just challenge me. They just go with the flow, you know. But she pushed back, and I can appreciate that. But with her future husband proposed to her, I still don't understand how I missed that invitation. But it's okay. And I thought I sent the picture of the ring to the studio, but it's in my phone, and I don't want to stop streaming with you guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep going. But I want to say shout out to Kimberly Adams, because that's gonna be your name. You gonna be Mrs. Adams. And like I told her, I'm so excited. Like, I mean, when I tell you this, she's been to the studio more than my own family. I don't even think they've been, but I'm just saying, she shows up. She be like, "You doing the show today?" I be like, "Not today, Kim. I'm gonna do a rerun." But she shows up. She got her Busy With B gear all the time. Whatever I got coming in, you would think I was Gucci, Chanel. I mean, the love that I just want to return it. So now it's my time to love on you. She showed up in her pink today. She didn't even know I was wearing pink. I think we just feeling the love. So she never want to come on camera. Just a little. Will, can you come and come on camera, Will? Please. Yo, why y'all acting so shy? I don't really need you. Because, I mean, the next topic, I mean, I was going to talk about. I was going to talk about entanglement. Yes, that's what it's. Come on, Will. Let's talk about this. I don't have nobody to talk with. Come on, Will. Come on. My producer said you having anybody up. I'm coming to you. Can I get the mic, please? I'm coming over there. Just stay right there.
No, he coming.
The camera already facing. I'm coming right over there. Come on.
I'm coming.
Can I go over there now?
Yeah.
So guys, Will just joined me in the studio. Didn't know he was gonna be on camera, but I'm always talking about relationships. He's just gotten engaged, so I know he needs to probably tread lightly. Okay, so with that being said, Will, we know everybody's talking about the entanglement. Everyone's talking about Will and Jada. Do you have anything as far as that relationship? I believe it was more open. I believe it was you know, a lot of things that's gone unsaid. I know Will's done a lot of things that did not make camera, okay? He's done a lot of things. But Jada stuff just came out. It could have been publicity. That's what people said. Or, you know, it was what it was. It came out. Would you hold your woman down if the shoe was on your foot?
Shoes on my foot. Well, I hold my baby down. It depends on how far we is in the relationship. If I'ma hold you down. So if he was like, you know, Will and Jada, you know, they been talking about for years, decades, basically, about their relationship. So, I mean, it wasn't really no surprise to me.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, the only thing surprised was, like you said, the entanglement, that the words she used, and Will was just shocked. Like, what you thought they was about to go, gonna be talking about coffee, and, I mean, over coffee, and just, you know, at a park or something.
Right.
Like, he ain't think that August, young as he is, that's older woman. I would have went for the mother if I was
him. I'm gonna tell you this. Like I said, I really feel like Will been off doing his own thing. Will been doing his thing for a long time, but it just never made camera. And it's not proven. But what I'm saying is, it's always different when a woman, you know, when we step and we do our thing, it's like, it's the y'all die. But when a man do the same thing, it's like, you know, we supposed to accept it. We forgive. We love. We love you through whatever. Is that?
Will loving her through whatever. That's why they gonna work it out, and they were so happy. You know, they been through this, and he knew about it. But like they said, this was 3-4 years ago. They done moved on and passed it. They gonna work it out as usual.
Mm.
And you know, and like I say, I mean, I think August still did that for his
entanglement
album,
song.
His album and all that. But you know, and I think, I don't know, Jada put a little extra spice with
on
the
it.
Word, you know.
So, one thing I would say is embarking on your new relationship. You know, it's gonna be so many things that come up. I think, if you can make it through, it's certain relationships that I've been fortunate to see, and shout out to the Glovers, but it's certain relationships that I love, you know, to see. I mean, and when I say that, I'm saying to see, I've seen unconditional love. I have a really good best friend who shown me what a man looked like and shown me what unconditional love looked like, right? And so I'm saying that to say, this is a whole new journey, you know, and what you go through really makes you, you know what I'm saying? We still kind of in the clay area of just morphing ourselves into who we need to be, you know, because you guys are fairly young. So, and I'm saying that to say that this is just the beginning, and you guys are going to have to come overcome a lot of things.
I like to tell her this is the easy part.
This is the easy part.
Challenges we're gonna have to face, all that longer years from now that we don't even see, that's, you know, but it's gonna be up to us to
make,
know,
it through,
keep it together, you know, and stick with it, you know.
I'm gonna ask you this though, and this is gonna be fun. How did you guys do with the lockdown, you know, with everything going on with the corona? A lot of relationships have been made or broken through this coronavirus situation. And I cannot let this go without having this beautiful couple in front of me. I've had much time to spend with you guys, so I've had time and I've spent time with you guys. How did you guys get through just being stuck together? Stuck like glue.
I loved it. For real, because, you know what I mean? Like you said, we have a happy relationship, you know? We had some ups and downs, but this, like, you know, I think we got stronger and was closer, spending more time with each other and talking about it, having deeper conversations, and, you know, about this corona situation,
mm-hmm,
that we, you know, don't have a clue what it is.
Mm-hmm.
We just going off what the news telling us.
Don't watch the news.
And, you know, and I still don't believe it, but, you know, they say it's true, it is.
Yeah.
So I think I've been through corona already.
Worse. I think we all have, though. It's really, I was going to talk about that on the show today, but I don't want to you know, bring a lot of attention to the coronavirus. I think it's nothing more than a cold. And stay away from the hospital, y'all. I mean, this is just what I feel. Unless you are literally dying, you know, go to the hospital. But don't let them put you on no ventilator. That's not how you treat the corona. But do your own research. That's another thing. We don't research nothing. That's why it's easy for us to believe whatever the news is telling us. So do what you got to do for yourself, guys. Love on yourself, all that good stuff. Well, you did awesome. When y'all going to come back? So y'all going to come back for a relationship show? Okay. When I say, like, I ask questions. Let's practice real quick. Practice. Yeah. So I ask questions like, I'm just gonna say who the most romantic. Don't say nothing. Hold up, look at her and talk about me. No, so I'm about to ask you another question, but I just want you to raise the microphone, okay? Don't even look at each other, look at me. Who's the freakiest? Why you ain't raise the microphone? You supposed to point at him. Okay, but he is. Okay, we learned some things about the Adams.
You know me, B. I'm 100 with you.
I know, right? These are the type of things that we do on a relationship show. We play games. I put y'all back to back, and I always find somebody to feed us. I always look for chefs and good music, good times, and create an environment and hopes to inspire other relationships that no matter what, you know, we can have true black love. So thank y'all for y'all segment. Will, I broke you in today. You are no longer a busy. It. You want to stop? Look at him. He broken in. That was it? Before I go to, oh y'all, why I forgot that I was on live? I supposed to have the camera over there with something. I don't know. Guys, I'm sorry. I really forgot I was streaming right here. I was all the way to the left. So we taking. What's my next Oh, so guys, so now that Buzy With B is getting sponsors, and thank you guys so much for the DMs. I got so many things I'm gonna tell you guys about, but guess what I have to do? I'm gonna take a commercial break. Guys, if you want to make an ad with me, if you want to donate to the cause, to the brand, it's really, really appreciated. Everything you see, guys, comes straight from me, out of my pockets. But I'm living a dream. I am super duper excited about being able to come and people actually listen. And I just pray that I'm inspiring someone to just go after your dream, no matter what you think it is. Just take that one leap, that one step, that one, you just never knows what it morph into. And I, like a year and a half ago, I walked in this studio and I didn't know what entailed for me. And I walked in here and I sat in front of Jeremy, just this nervous wreck. But I knew I wanted to do this because God had spoken over me so strong. He kept waking me up at night. He wouldn't let me sleep. And I did a video on Facebook and it got over 1,000 views. And people was like, you really spoke to my heart. And I didn't know what I was saying. I was speaking from my heart. So, guys, just do one step of anything you think you want to try. You just trust them. And you just do one piece of it. And I promise you, it has turned into my business. I have a 501c3, guys. It's called Buzy Being Beautiful. I'm trying to do more things in the community. You guys will see me in the parks. And you will see me giving away things. I have so many things coming. But it starts with you guys, because everything that I do will be done off of donations. Even I may include the show into that. So guys, I'm really looking for you to help me help many people. So that's really my vision, to just be able to stand in front of millions, motivate and inspire. But right here, right now, I am taking a commercial break, guys. So if you're on Facebook, I'll still be streaming, but Guys, I'm taking a commercial break in the studio. Peace.
The best of being busy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get busy with B.
What we talk about, charity, celebrity, what we talk about, therapy, prosperity, what we talk about, I'm from the nation cap, home of the Nats, we winning on you Bama's, baby, best believe that, we losing our youth, the black on black violence with straps, can't depend on politicians, gotta watch our own back, put the guns down, youngins, life's about funning, hate to see funerals, but love to give money, shout out to VA and PG, you see us coming, MDDC, be more what it do, dummy.
Getting busy with being, getting busy.
We'll be right back.
a destiny. You are meant for me, so it's meant to be. You are.
So guys, let me say, Will did so good that I am going to call him back up. We're going to kind of end the show like that. But, you know, I'm DMV based. I'm home based. I love everything about this city. I wish I could afford to really, truly live in the city the way we deserve to live. But I want to talk about Mass Up. Shout out to Mass Up, right? Hashtag Mass Up. Busy Will B. I'm about to start giving away prizes, all of that good stuff. Mass Up DC, Mute Corona, all that good stuff. But definitely put that Busy Will B right there too, okay? Y'all need the hashtag. You know what I noticed? I'm really doing good with my Busy Will B hashtags. And thank you guys for following. I have almost 300 people following the hashtag Busy Will B. That's so dope. So, guys, I want to talk about the mask up, making it mandatory to wear a mask even when you're outside. How do you guys feel about that? Because, wow. I think that's another way for us to be targeted as Black people. If we're in the poor communities, that is a way for us to be targeted, be arrested, be harassed. It has been another thing that the mayor has added for the poor community. I'm sure that we're going to see more things on Facebook. We're going to see more things going down that could have been solved and unnecessary. I feel like they want us to buy into this corona because it's a bigger picture. Because they shutting us up with the mask. They muting us with the mask, first of all. They putting a mute on us. We can't see each other smile. We can't see each other expressions. So this is the first step, guys. And I feel like as long as we keep remaining silent. Now, don't get it wrong. It is something in the air. It is something going on. And trust me, you guys may not even see this video anymore. Because when you speak against the corona, everybody disappears. Please don't let Busy be disappear, okay? But what I'm saying is, no, I'm dead. I'm laughing. But it's really a serious topic. You're a conspiracy theorist, and it's if you speaking against it, but I would tell anyone to do your own research, okay? You have doctors speaking about wearing your mask. You have people speaking out and going against everything that they are taught, okay, for not wearing these masks, okay? I feel like even me personally, I've experienced the coronavirus. I feel like, you know, when I wear the mask, it makes me sicker. I feel like this 6 feet separation is just another way to separate us. It's not personally how I feel. I just ask any of my Busy Will B supporters, guys, to do your own research, okay? Do your own research. Do your own research, okay? Oh, excuse me. I'm so sorry. So I wanted to talk about that. I want to touch on Kanye West, okay? I definitely want to. Can you turn this light back around right here? Yeah. So I'm watching. Oh, hold up, wait. Thank you. I need light. You know, I'm dark skinned. I need to be seen. So I wanted to touch on Kanye West. You guys, if you don't know, I'm just going to start with saying mental health is truly an illness. And I know in the Black community, I know even with myself, you know, going through depression, I went through depression for a very long time, even before I knew what it was. For a big part of my life, I really didn't even know what I was going through when I didn't want to get out of the bed, it's serious. And in the Black community, we don't talk about it. And I was very young, full of anxiety, full of depression. Didn't really know what was going on with me. I would go to the doctor. I would have anxiety attacks. I would get full physicals. I would do everything. And the doctor would say I was okay. And it wasn't until I saw it on Soul Food. I would never forget because the sister had a real bad panic attack. It wasn't Bird, but it was the other sister. and she was couldn't breathe, and she felt like she, I mean, the movie just painted that picture, and I was able to identify, oh my gosh, this is what happens to me. And I knew, and every time I would get my grandmother, because that's who raised me, I would get my grandmother to take me to the doctor because something was wrong. I'm always feeling like I'm about to die, and you really feel like that. And I was 8, 9 years old, so that just tells you a little bit about my background. And you guys are going to have to read my book, okay, to really get into that. But I used to have these real bad anxiety attacks, and as I got older, I would get super depressed. And if anybody knows me closely, I think Kim has observed me long enough to really see that I'm really, really like an introvert. And that I'm just at a point now where I truly protect my energy. I do like to have fun. I'm very social, but I'm really not open a lot. You know, I don't say, come into my life. You know what I mean? I'm not like that. Like, even when I'm around a crowd, I kind of like close up. And so it's just, I don't know what it is. Mental health is so serious, guys. We don't talk about it. We need to talk about it more. But when I got to witness Kanye West, I had to get back to Kanye. When I got to witness him, and I seen his press conference. And if you guys don't know, he's running for president. Allegedly running for president. I think he just want to get people together and could have an album coming out. But he do like to be in front of a crowd. But he was in front of a majority white crowd. It was a black young lady in the crowd. And he went off on her. I mean, you guys got to watch the video. Matter of fact, I didn't want to post it on my page, but I will. But it's just like he's crying, guys. He is talking about his kids and something he almost did to his kids. And Kim released a statement. And when I say it goes on and on, and to me, this is not funny. And to me, I'm like, who is in his camp to wheel him back in? Who is around him not being his yes man? You know, so guys, I'm just saying, we're going to have shows on mental health. We're going to talk about it. I've even, in the past, invited my own personal therapist to the studio. And guys, I'm telling you, therapy was one of the things that really saved my life. And I know as entering you guys, married couple, I will always say, I haven't been married yet, though. And if you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. See, I'm having a mental moment. But guys, I'm just saying, therapy has truly been like my best friend. Like, I really, and it's different forms of therapy, you know. But I'm just saying, be open. You know, I've dealt with a lot of childhood issues through therapy. Forgiving my dad. And so that's what my book is called, Forgiving My Dad. Because a lot of my issues came from men, you know, and who I invited in my life. And overall, even if you put my two men together, that's my child's fathers, they are pieces of my dad, you know. And one just really smooth, and one smooth in public, but a monster behind closed doors. So, and I say that to say that until we really deal with those issues, we can't truly love on ourselves. Because once, I mean, and I want to be clear, since I brought that up, a lot of my spiritual growth and a lot of me is just being accountable for me, right? So I forgive myself first. I had to forgive myself, forgive the people that I felt wrong me. But ultimately, I had to take accountability because people only do what you let them do. So meaning, I didn't see who I was, so how could I expect anyone to see the value in me? You understand? So now that I truly know who I am, you know, I can't have it no other way. So it's not really cockiness. It's like I'm grateful. So I'm thankful that everything that I've been through, I had to go through to get to who I am today, okay? Okay, I got these beautiful babies, but I'm saying whatever your issues is, mine was forgiving my dad. I got a book coming, and it's called Forgiving My Dad, okay? And so whatever your issues is, therapy can truly save your life and can truly kind of get you to talking, getting you to be around people that can understand you more and all that good stuff. So it's more so like Mike is sending me text messages, y'all. So if I'm getting a little thrown off, I'm reading everything coming through the phone, and now I need to switch topics. But guys, I hope you guys got something out of that piece of the segment, you know, and everything. So you're getting little pieces of me here, because that's, I love to pull from my experiences, because I feel like it's just giving you a little piece of me. Mike wants to. Now, we should talk about the election. Mike said, register to vote. Come on, feed me. Go ahead. This how, see, normally, see, like, in Ellen's ear, because y'all know I'm on Ellen's couch one day, right? So, in her ear, like, she have her team to tell her, you know, what to say, feed her things, okay? So when God surrounded me with people to help me feed, you know, feed things to me, you know, let me live, okay? So I'm going to act like we advanced, right? We already on Ellen's couch. I'm already a black virgin of Ellen. Only, you know, not Ellen. But so, guys, register to vote. 2020, November the 3rd. Election day, it really do count. November the 3rd, guys, if you don't do anything else, get out and vote, okay? No matter how you feel, no matter who you vote for, I mean, at the end of the day, you really need to read the, you know, it's Democrats and Republicans, I know, okay? But get out and vote something, okay? We seen what happened last election. I think everybody focused so much on Trump that he ended up winning. I don't know. The energy just flew that way. So where your energy go, you know, it flows. So I'm just saying get out and vote. I'm not saying, honestly, I'm so torn between these candidates. I cannot say Joe Biden is, you know, or I don't even want to say his name on the show, okay? But but what I'm saying is, guys, exercise your right to vote. We've had so many people die just for that. You know, so many people to sacrifice their lives for us to have a chance to vote. So get out and vote, guys, if you don't do anything else. I'm looking. So look, y'all, let me tell y'all what I'm doing. I'm looking at Mike. He my voice in my ear. Vote local.
Your local elections matter.
Let me leave him alone. But listen, I want to, no, definitely, guys, get out and vote. I want to send some, I had so much fun with the entanglement segment that I kind of wanted to get back to that, close out the show. And so we gonna do that. We gonna so let me also what I'm gonna do is the show is actually kind of over. I have a conference call. Okay, so guys, what I'm gonna say is Buzy With B is looking to be in the community the second Monday in August. Maybe that weekend. I don't know the exact date yet, but I'm gonna be in a park, a local park. And I want you guys to come down. I'm going to try to just do my thing. You know, crabs. I got some friends that have crabs. I mean, I just want to kind of just, what we going to call that show? A picnic with friends? I don't know. We come up with these names, guys. But most, like, you guys are doing so well with following me, with showing me so much love on Facebook and Instagram. I'm joining Twitter. I'm on Twitter. Guys, when I say I'm so grateful, because I never thought, you know, one step of faith would lead me here, to be comfortable, to be able to sit in front of you for a whole hour and carry the show, figure it out. I'm just forever grateful, guys. But we're going to end the show with our entanglements segment. Larry Moody, thank you. Thank you. Oh, you know I like music. You got that mic? Let me light some sage for all those haters that made my day rough. I'm going to close out the... I don't know what they are. I better watch what I'm saying. They probably watching. You know them be the ones that be watching. They treat you like crap. And then they be your biggest fans. But y'all... Man, what? I'm lighting my stage to close out the show. Shout out to Danita Cooper. Y'all, she gets my hair right. I love her so. She's getting married too. I might, oh my gosh, I might just do something with, I'm getting more and more. See, all this love is around me. I love myself so much. I know my husband. Come in. I'm claiming it because I'm surrounded with so much love. And I promise you, once you love yourself, like I promise you, everybody just loves you. I promise. It just comes. But you creepy people, you know who you are. Stay out my inbox. I done blocked quite a bit. Can't depend on politicians, gotta watch our own back. Put the guns down, youngins. Life's about running. Hate to see funerals, but love to give money. Shout out to VA and PG. You see us coming in. BBC, be more what it do, dummy. Getting busy with B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Getting busy with B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free.
Yeah,
5 minutes. Yay. Don't get my feet, because they so cute. I don't see Will microphone. Will microphone. Huh? We got Shay. We don't. Thank you. 5 minutes. You know how much conversation we can have in 5 minutes. So, I did want to let you off the hook, right? And I don't know if this is always a good thing, but we talked about Will and Jada and their entanglement. As a man, have you ever experienced an entanglement? Just give me a brief synopsis.
Oh, plenty.
Plenty?
Not plenty. But, I mean, because I only been married once. Because, I mean, I'm looking at Will's situation as merged. So, no, I haven't. But, I mean, far as, like, if you want to say we wasn't in a husband and wife setting as Will and Jada was, I mean, I think everyone had an entanglement.
I definitely.
Without the marriage certificate.
I didn't volunteer for the entanglement, but it happens.
I know.
It happens.
Exclude the relationship part and merge. I think everyone has.
So, how long have your longest relationship been?
My longest, 7 years.
7 years. Kim?
11 years.
What makes you guys ready to, you know, like, I mean, is it a feeling? Like, I'm really asking, you know, just as a single woman, is it like, do you know?
I believe that, and I'm mad we only had 5 minutes and you can put me on the camera.
Okay,
I'm sorry. I believe our relationship was established with an entanglement, but it was based off of me not being ready. I hindered him and I moving forward. It was my entanglement where I was wrong, and I really honestly didn't know how to accept a real man. Like, it was a man in my face, and I really honestly didn't recognize he was a man.
Mm-hmm.
And this little entanglement that I got us in, I needed to untangle us.
Hmm.
And now we're an engagement. So an entanglement turned into an engagement, and it's going to last forever. Like,
amen.
Yeah.
So, I'm mad, y'all, that I only had 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Because, again, totally, Kim is always acting shy, but she always have the right stuff to say at the right time. But I really would love for you guys to come back. You know, maybe I never had a bridal shower.
Shout out to us being childhood friends for like 20 years.
For real?
Yes.
Okay.
Since we were children.
Okay.
Okay.
And so y'all start dating later on in life, or how'd that go?
Yes, later on in life. A year ago.
That's it.
Yes.
Y'all are really newlyweds.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So guess what? We're going to follow this couple. Okay. No, we really are. Like, I'm invested anyway. So I really, you know, I have never had a bridal shower. I'm going to, like, invite the girls. Like, I'm all about just having a bridal party, Busy With B style. We talk about topics. You know, who knows? We might even wear some nice PJs. I won't say lingerie. I'll just say PJs. Guys, but Thank you so much for sharing this stage with me and helping me get through one of my full shows alone. And it was really good. I really enjoyed myself. But guys, you know, each and every Monday, I call it Busy With B Mondays. No matter what's going on, no matter how I'm feeling, when I get in front of this camera, when I get to do the one thing that I love in the world, it's just like, I really, you know how Beyonce says she's Sasha? I'm busy. You know, when I get to get in front of you guys and do what I love to do, it fills me. And so I'm filled for the week. It's like going to church and getting everything you need to last for the rest of the week. So this just reminds me of the day I had. It reminds me of why I push and why I keep going so hard. So don't let that negative thing keep you there. You use that to fuel you up. For anything you trying to do, you know, and know that when things come against you, that's the time when you fight even harder. You push even stronger. Because everything that's trying to break me, it always build me up. I promise. I'm not easily broken. So each and every Monday right here, Listen Vision Studios. Thank you so much for following me. Guys, go follow me on YouTube. Go follow me on Instagram. I see you on Facebook. I love you guys. And I will see you next week right here on the Listen Vision. Peace.
I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Getting busy with being, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free.
Getting busy with me, getting busy with me. She too busy being beautiful, it's busy to be. We busy being busy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get busy with me.
Busy with B, getting busy with B. We busy being brilliant, breaking down your issues with B. The best of being busy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get busy with B.
Oh, what we talk about, we can talk it out, latest news, advertisement, what we bark about, charity, celebrity, what we talk about, therapy, prosperity, what we talk about, I'm from the nation cap, home of the net.